We also can, so E is a quantity you've heard of before, delta L over L. One that's not commonly thought about is a quantity called the stretch. And the stretch is defined as final length over initial length. And it turns out this is the quantity you typically measure when you measure strain in materials. The stretch is not E. And so we'll come back to that a little bit later. But if you relate stretches back to this quantity, stretch is final length minus initial length, so stretch in the x direction is delta, little delta x, final length over, oops, big delta x, final length over initial length. And big delta, this is little delta y over big delta y. Turns out both of these appear in different formulations of the theory of strain. One comes up in one formulation in the context of coordinate references. The other one comes up in terms of displacement. And either one works. They're just different. But they're different quantities. It's important to understand that they're measuring the same thing. They're just different measures of the same quantity. I should also note that you could extend this to three dimensions by just adding another term. I could draw a box instead of a square. So you could also have S Z is big delta Z, little delta Z, big delta Z, and so forth over there. Doesn't matter, it's the same idea. We're not gonna bother with three dimensions right at the moment, but you get the idea that it's all related to switching the shape of a box, right? Let's talk about something that is abused by geologists repeatedly that's related to these two quantities. Let's talk about E and S first. This is delta L over L, and this is final over L. This one's actually easier to start with than the other one. What is zero strain in this quantity? No strain.
Are you
out of
order?
Huh? What would the value of this quantity be?
One.
When they're
one.
With one. When strain is zero. S equals one. Counterintuitive, right? But there's a reason for that. What happens with shortening? If you shorten something, how does its quantity change? What's its range?
It
starts at one, right?
Yeah, it'll be less than one.
Be less than one. What's its limit? What's infinite strain?
Zero.
So shortening. Range is from 1 to 0. So it's less than 1. What's lengthening? That says lengthening, sorry.
Greater than 1?
Greater than 1. Range is from 1 to infinity. Because in the limit, that can go to infinity. Right? So there's a weird non-linearity betwixt these two numbers. That's important to remember. One, they're kind of reciprocals of each other in reality. But in terms of numerical values, there's this counterintuitive thing. This blows up, and this goes to nothing. The strain increases in the two different senses. What about this one? Remember, this is final minus addition over addition. So what's no strain on this one?
Zero.
So what's its range of value? Let's go to shortening. What's its range?
Negative. So,
goes negative, because this value, is always going to be less than that, right?
Mm-hmm.
What's the limit? The ultimate, infinite shortening What does that go to? Zero. So what does this quantity become?
Negative 1.
So shortening.
Zero to negative 1.
To -1. And correspondingly the other way around, the long elongation, the long or lengthening, I should call it. That
zero to
up,
one.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
So it goes from 0 to infinity.
Mm.
How are these related to each other? They're exact, this illustration of it, they're exactly the same thing. This ranges from 1 to 0. This goes from 0 to minus 1. That goes from 1 to infinity. And I did it backwards, sorry. But you get the idea? You see what I'm... They are related to each other. That e plus 1 is s.
Hmm.
I do it backwards. That's E. Yeah, E plus 1 gives S. So why is that? Well, that's not too hard.
Mm-hmm.
You add 1 to LF minus LI over LI. If you add LI over LI to that,
mm-hmm.
those cancel. You have LF over LI. And they're related to each other that way. That's elongation straight. Why do I belabor them? 90% of geologists out there, maybe more, will throw out a number and say, there's X percent strain. And they don't tell you which number they're talking about.
Mm-hmm.
Right? And there are two different numbers, actually. Especially in elongation. It can be very confusing. It's not so much, usually when you're talking about shortening, it's not so hard to separate them out. When people talk about elongation, they're very, very different quantities. Like they're off by a factor of 1. There's a big difference between a stretch of 2 and AE of 2 in the context of how much motion is involved. But it gets worse. That's not all. There are other measures of strain. Oh, wrong. No.